when we are fighting, we would say what is crucial is food, gun, and ammunition. Clothes optional. Because a naked person can shoot you and you die. So you would find people with buttocks outside. But they can shoot you. That's how we manage it. There is what was immediate. Food. Not even medicine. Because medicine, we could get it from the government. Once we successfully attack, we take government medicine. So what was crucial was food, so that we walk and get to where we are going, and the gun and the bullet. Actually, when I went to see Gaddafi, I met Gaddafi on the 21st of June, 1981. And he asked me, he said, what do you need? I said, ammunition and gun. You don't want men? I said, no. You don't want clothes? I said, no. You don't want medicine? I said, no. Ammunition and gun, finish. On the key. Gaddafi was surprised. Because Gaddafi used to support many people, they would come and say, we want money, want radio for propaganda. Radio, once I shoot you, then propaganda is... So please, if you are dealing with the problems, ask people who have dealt with problems before, and I'm here. Okay? I am here, I will give you free consultancy. You don't have to pay me, I'm just here. How to work with little. The good thing, maybe some of the problem is that some of you have never seen problems. I had to interrupt my life for 8 years in Tanzania fighting Idi Amin. 8 years. Whatever I was doing, I left. We left, not me alone. 5 years in the bush. That's a total of 13 years. Now, we came back. Is anybody better off than myself? The one who lost 13 years? The thing was to survive, as long as I survive. Even if I lose time, even if I lose what? If there is such a big danger, it is better than dying. Oh, pregnancy. Pregnancy, that means there are two people now instead of one. You know, when I hear these people talking, are these children or what? Or are they adults? Eh? When we went to fight, some of the children left school and joined us in the bush. Some were young children. They went out and joined us in the bush. When we came back, after many years of fighting, we started a Kadogo school for them in Mbarara there, a Kadogo school. So all the Kadogos in the army, you come and resume your abandoned education. Next year on the Teacher's Day, I will bring those Kadogos here. The ones who left education, went and joined us in the bush, fought. Then long after, after many years of getting out of school, they came back. We opened a special school for them in Mbarara. Many of them are now doctors, what? You cannot. I thought teachers knew something about like and unlike terms. That's what I had when I was still in the education system. There are like and unlike. You cannot compare the uncomparables. Don't compare death with losing time, losing jobs, losing money. That is reversible. I can lose today, tomorrow I will gain. But death is irreversible. You are dead, finished. So how can you go on comparing these two, like and unlike terms, and then you say you are teachers? What are you teaching now? To compare the uncomparables. There's no way we can compare death with loss. I lost 13 years of my life. But I am here. I even came back with a wife. And with children, because I didn't have a wife when I went. So please stop. It's good you have given me opportunity to lambast this confusion. Even our people, our Baganda people, they know this. They say, "Ekitata muyima tekimara." Do you have real Baganda here? Kanda oba waru Baganda dara. Go. Kati oba waru Baganda aja amare yorugero rwangoro. Anyambi okumara yorugero. Jangu kumzindaro wali bakula miyengo sikuetaga. Abaganda abalala. Genda weyangire ate ntegereda ntori Muganda dara.
Erinye lyange nze namande Grace Nakanwaji nediranga bi akabiro jerengesa. Ekitata muima tekimmala akontezi.
Uri disebo ne nyabo. Nakanwaji atuyambye. The Baganda were able to study their neighbors, the Wanyankore, the cattle keepers, the Bahima. Say, if a Muhima doesn't die, even if he loses cattle, he will get new cows. Because so what is important is life. So please stop this. This is wrong. Of course, for me, I will not listen. As long as God has put me here to protect my people, I can't listen to all this confusion. Pregnancy. Jobs. I don't know. You go and do something, Jesus. If you are running a bar, and the bar has been closed by a catastrophe, Olumbe, Ruze, Nebagamati Okwetasa, Mugareo Bara, Nenebera Wan Mutauni. Then I guess that I go to the village and start cultivating potatoes. Has Corona stopped cultivating potatoes? If you plant potatoes, will they not grow? Will Corona stop them? Yeah, this Corona came, created problems, especially anything to do with congregating people was a problem. Now, if that is a problem, I go and do something else. As long as I am alive. So, don't compare the uncomparables. Because Baguma and his committee are behaving as if we don't know that education matters. Who said it didn't matter? When was it said, and who said, education matters, but we had to survive. I really don't like this question of people being not knowing what to do. What the Bible says, the book of Manyankore Tomburzi, Ecclesiastes, says there is time for everything. This time was for survival, and I'm very, very proud that we shielded our people from dying. I was watching TV just the other two nights ago. There's a country known as Brazil. They were showing that Brazil has reached the level of 600,000 deaths abafu emitwaro enkaga who died from corona. 600,000 dead in Brazil. You teachers union, you must be having this internet. You go and check how many people died in Brazil. I was told yesterday that there were 600,000 the other night. The US, those ones reached 600,000 long ago. 600,000 dead. All these European countries, you go and check how many people died here, died there, died there, died there. Am I going to say that I am happy that our people didn't die so much? We were able to save our people from, we have reached now 3,000 something. All this month, 1 year, and 7 months, only 3,000 people have died. You think that's not important?